smash people. Let's see what they can do here in game number one, bringing in a Fury Warrior for what I think maybe the first time we've seen its specialization here in 2019. Curious to see how it plays it out. I know that you've had a lot of experience with it yourself, Adrian.
Yeah, they're taking a bit of a page out of me, Nali, and Joe Fernandez's book here. We're currently ranked 30, I believe, in NA with this composition, so it's a very solid one. And the main strengths of this comp is the Windwalker has a lot of off-healing. The Fury Warrior also has a lot of off-healing. So against the Shadow Priest Rock Pressure, both these melees are going to do a great job of firstly shutting down the Shadow Priest, but also, you know, just avoid healing through any kind of like lingering damage that comes out of the Shadow Priest. That said, I actually don't mind this matchup for Change My Mind. I feel like Vilai is going to have a really easy time surviving against this. So it's going to come down to mana. Potentially they can kind of Minpoike in the late game. But Vilai's playing, I know, this very tanky build. He's going full versatility. He's actually prioritizing the Azeroth traits, Twist of Magic, which basically whenever he purges, he heals his entire team. So he is a tank on that Shadow Priest. I don't know if the boys have accounted for that.
Yeah, changed my mind. Focus on crowd control. So Vilai running the Mind Bomb, as it's very difficult to move as a Shadow Priest with multiple melee running at you. That Mind Bomb is ranged crowd control that he can access and remove Gorecki as we see it activated. But Vilai is still low on health and can't dish out any damage during that crowd control moment. Acro gets switched to as well. Gorecki gets sapped at the end of this, though. Trying to stall it out. They pull Touch of Karma from Chun-Li. Cooldowns exchanged on both sides. I would say potential lead here for Change My Mind, despite not having Fried Kitty here to compete in the tournament. They're looking solid in game one.
Yeah, I mean, that was the Touch of Death. It was the Way of the Crane, and they didn't even need to trade out the Dispersion there on Vilai, so definitely a reasonable trade. Now we see the swaps coming over onto Chun-Li. Beautiful Cyclone from Minpoike, and this is another thing I want to highlight for Change My Mind. Like, Minpoike, Zeke and I didn't rank him as, like, you know, the number one or number two healers in the world, but when it comes to uniquely the Restoration Druid, he has seen a lot of success over the years. He's one of the kind of more old school healers from Europe, still showing his stuff here in this competition. A big swap, though, over onto Akrolos, forces out the evasion. This could be a good swap from the boys. I feel like Vilai is really difficult to kill. Tunneling Akrolos could be the weakness.
Now they've got two targets low on health. I mean, Poike has no Iron Bark. How will they recover from this? Akro retreats away with Sprint. Vilai getting crushed. And Poike connecting some big Nourish heals, managing to stabilize and get the team back to full and regenerate some mana amidst that. Good recovery by Change My Mind. The boys still trying to chop up Akro. And Poike is locked down in crowd control. No follow-up. Akro avoids the fight for now. Curious to see when Change My Mind are going to strike again. They need to be careful pushing forward. Touch of Death available for Chun-Li. Gorecki anticipating an attack and activating Life Cocoon before any crowd control is engaged, denying huge damage. But now that that Life Cocoon is faded, an opening opens up for Change My Mind.
Yeah, I actually want to commend Minpoike as well on his mana management this game. I think as the Restoration Druid, it's easy to keep your team alive at the expense of your mana pool, but he actually has a pretty even one with Gorecki right now, which is no easy feat for the Restoration Druid, so well played by him so far in this game. Akrilol is trying to get aggressive, like you said. The Vendetta traded out a little bit there. We see the Void Eruption Insanity unleashed from Vilai, trying to get some pressure over onto Gorecki's mana bar, and that's ultimately what they're achieving here. Chun-Li dropping lower and lower, does have that Touch of Karma, though. We see the Bash coming in. They're trying to get some crowd control going here, but a nice Touch of Karma from Chun-Li should deny a lot of this incoming damage from Change My Mind.
And Poike playing it smartly and held out on going for a Cyclone and Gorecki. That would put him on diminishing return for Mind Bomb, and as Chun-Li already had defensive cooldowns active, it was unlikely that he was going to die at that moment in time, saving that diminishing return for a later time and try to find a kill opportunity. But it's Vilai who's in trouble. 1 second away from that dispersion. Iron Bark of Minpoike will save the day, but it's Way of the Crane from Chun-Li, so he's adding some extra damage to the team. Akro, realizing that, is able to sort of duck away with Feint and avoid the pressure for now. Minpoike gets interrupted. They drop the Smoke Bomb, but Gorecki predicted it once again, activating that Life Cocoon right before a big push from Change My Mind, denying the kill. But look at the mana. Gorecki's almost tapped. Minpoike, I do believe, is sitting down in stealth. Regenerated a significant amount. Still has cooldowns to exchange. And even though they're a man down, Change My Mind might be able to do this if they can hold on a bit longer.
Yeah, I mean, that was a fantastic trade for Change My Mind. They got the drink, they traded Dispersion for Touch of Death and 3 Maledicts from the boys, so fantastic trade for Change My Mind. Looking good, like you said, just 3 members here. We don't have Fried Kitty, who participated in, like I said, 90% of the games for Change My Mind, but it's forced them to really learn and perfect this Shadow Priest rogue composition, and it's looking good for them so far. Gorecki down to about 15% mana left. Chun-Li without Touch of Karma for a few seconds, but they do a big swap over onto Akrolos, forcing out the Trinket Evasion once again. I think they need to do more more of these swaps said if they are to secure the game.
Free life cocoon on the incoming blind. Gurecki predicting every single crowd control attempt of Change My Mind and really not leaving any significant holes in his defense. Although still crowd controlled, Chun-Li has to trade. Touch of Karma now out of the way, and Change My Mind stay in the fight. Dampening has kicked in. Both healers are almost tapped on mana, and this game will be ending shortly as a result, unless one of them can escape and drink. But Smexen wants to crush out Acro. He's got Minpoike locked out in crowd control. Valet can't support either. Acro gets gripped. Smexen leaps over. Chun-Li in hot pursuit. Gurecki interrupts the heal, but Chun-Li can't follow up. He's stunned away by Acro. Change My Mind desperately trying to stabilize, and Minpoike is still crowd controlled. This could be the Void Shift. Valet fades. He immunes incoming damage during Fade's activation, holding out at low health, but it's costing Minpoike a lot of mana to recover if they don't exchange cooldowns at this time. Gurecki, he needs to find some mana for another Way of the Crane. If he can do that, he can easily push Valet over, but if he's not able to, I think things may spiral out of control for the boys.
Yeah, I mean, Valet still has the dispersion. You know, he can trade that happily. He has the Void Shift, that life-swapping ability that's so powerful for the Shadow Priest, and Chun-Li is very much without those major cooldowns. They're bursting through this bubble coming in from Gurecki. They're doing a fantastic job forcing the reverse magic here. Chun-Li in so much trouble at this moment in time. The full kidney shot, he does have the trinket. He's not using it. Fortifying Brew comes out late. Gurecki is completely tapped on mana. Desperation swap over onto Minpoike from Smexen, but I don't think it'll be enough.
Okay.
Villai still has the life swap. They're so far ahead in this game, they're just gonna kill Chun-Li.
Four more seconds, three to that Touch of Karma, but Gurecki's locked out in crowd control. He trinkets the Mind Bomb into a bash. Great follow-up by Minpoike. Chun-Li, Touch of Karma barely trades in time. Now Minpoike crowd control. Both teams in trouble. Maybe a cross kill. Dispersion stabilizes Villai. They're so far behind on cooldowns. They catch a big revival heal. Chun-Li holds out, but they've got no counter pressure. They go for the kill. They've got the intimidating shot of Minpoike. It's do or die. Can they take Valet out in time? I don't think they're gonna be able to do it. Chun-Li portals away, but he's so low on health, and Gurecki's caught in a full blind. Change My Mind, despite having their mage, or not having their mage here today, are slowly pulling this off. Chun-Li holding out. Acro Shadow steps in, locks him in place for Valet. Huge Void Bolt, big connect. Gurecki cannot stabilize. How did he do it? Chun-Li manages to stay alive, gets cycloned at low health. I was starting to count the boys out, but I guess you can never count the boys out.
You can't count the boys out. You can't count Chun-Li out. There's a reason that a lot of people say this guy is the best Windwalker monk in the world, but we see the smoke bomb coming in. Beautiful preemptive Fist of Fury coming in from Chun-Li. Once again, playing the dangerous game. Full Mind Bomb over onto Gurecki. Chun-Li running for his dear life at this moment in time. Dampening starting to tick away. Change My Mind are completely tapped on mana, but they have defensive cooldowns available. The life swap, that big defensive. Minpoike looking for a little drink right now. They need to stop that. They need to get over to him. Looks like he's getting good mana at this moment in time. About 30%. Gurecki does not have that luxury, and that's going to put them further ahead.
Touch of Death available for Chun-Li. Acro does not have a Gladiator's Medallion. Why did Chun-Li not commit the Touch of Death? I guess he wants to wait for the Iron Bark. Do they really have time to wait for it? I think Touch of Death would have just killed Acro right here and now. They might just do it anyway. Both members
the Void
crowd control, and he cannot activate it for one more second. Barely squeezed that in, but with Touch of Death, Acro died there. Was that a mistiming by Chun-Li?
Potentially. I mean, maybe he wanted to get that Void Shift out. I mean, they almost killed without it because of the paralysis, but like without his trinket. And maybe you're right, Sid. Maybe that was the throwaway. Actually, a DR Fear coming out on some Minpoike, it looked like there as well. The Touch of Death is now committed.
This has to be it.
Has to be the kill, but they're just going to trade the dispersion once again. Villai so smart with his cooldowns. Chun-Li now caught up. Does have the Touch of Karma available, the big defensive cooldown. This game is really on a knife's edge at this point.
Yes, it is. Dampening's very high. Both teams tapped on mana. Chun-Li, Touch of Karma's at 10%. Minpoike's in position. Jumps on top of Gurecki. He's in a Mind Bomb. Any follow-up. Smexen leaps over, interrupts him. Sap out of Mind Bomb. Sap on the trinket. Style moves here by Acro and Change My Mind. Great follow-up, but once again, Chun-Li, that Ring of Peace positioning prevented Acro from connecting. He finally is dishing out huge damage. Life Cocoon available in one more second for Gurecki as he manages to stay alive.
Yeah, Minpoike had a second of hesitation there. If he got the low cyclone, he might have actually cycloned the life cocoon, chose to cancel it. Maybe that was not the play. not the move. Since we're playing some Rogue Priest, we might as well throw that one out there. Evasion was used aggressively there by Akrilos, as was Trinket, and now they're looking to punish. Full stun, Mimpoike's drinking on the other side of the map. He needs to get back an excellent life grip from Villai, keeping his Rogue potentially alive here, but he's still in trouble. That was a lot of defensive cooldowns burnt on the side of Changed My Mind. I'd love to see if Greki can get enough mana for one more Wave of the Crane, one more offensive push. It has to be onto Akro, surely.
Dampening gets higher and higher. The mana is just continuing to go down, and cooldowns are burned on both sides. There's basically nothing left for either team as they battle it out. Game number one, the final upper bracket match. Will Europe win 3 out of 4 in the upper bracket, or will the boys manage to tie it for North America 2-2? We will find out here shortly as we see Change My Mind changing targets.
Both the healers actually managed to get a drink there. I can't believe that. They're choosing to swap target over onto Smexin's. Dampening starts to stack up. I actually don't mind that, but I just feel like Chun-Li is the more exposed target. He has less armor. He's easier for Akro to lay into the fear onto Mimpoike, who also got a good drink in that exchange. He's trinketing out of that one. Villai drops a little bit low, uses the Greater Fade, still has that dispersion available to him. The double stun, this should be a swap over onto Akro. They're actually tunneling down Villai through it. They get the dispersion. There's no cooldowns available for the Touch of Death now.
Greki's
I think that's still going to tick. Greki has 4 mana. We see the smoke bomb coming out. Trinket from Smexin doesn't even trade out the heals. He should be fine. Villai in so much trouble.
The boys are doing it. They're coming back in this fight. Desperation times here for Change My Mind. Even though Mimpoike has mana, mana is more valuable. The Way of the Crane is more than enough. The boys battle it back for game one.
Trying to do just that, but already their backs against the wall.
This is the Arena World Championship 2019 Spring Finals, where we bring the 4 top teams from Europe and the 4 top teams from North America to battle it out for a $50,000 prize and a qualification straight to BlizzCon. This is the final upper bracket round. Europe currently leads 6-3 for the day, but the boys are looking to battle it back for their region and tie it up. Already taking game one against Change My Mind, but even without their Mage Fried Kitty, they are still putting up quite a formidable fight.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how Smexin on the Death Knight differs from Smexin on the Warrior in this matchup. I honestly think it's going to be slightly better for Change My Mind. They have more interrupts, their anti-magic shell and zone are both solid defensives. You can see the pressure already starting to amount over onto Villai. Trinkets used from him, Iron Bark once again from Mimpoike, good innovate just early. I really like these innovates. He gets a lot of healing out for free, gets that cooldown on rotation, and in a long game like this, it could potentially be good, but I mean, just the raw damage from the Abomination, that wasn't even the Touch of Death, and Villai already training out Dispersion. I'd love to see them use Touch of Death before that Fade comes up, but it would have to be now.
Smexin is flexing and shredding here in game number 2, switching from Fury Warrior onto the Unholy Death Knight, already burning through significant defensive cooldowns of the team Change My Mind. We see crowd control initiated by Villai. Way of the Crane gets blinded. This is likely a trinket. Where's the punish on the trinket? No punish. Way of the Crane's going to be doing tons of pressure. Villai fades to immune incoming damage. Well timed there, preventing Greki from getting some extra burst, but ultimately, 3 members will connect. That's the Touch of Death. This is going to be a big hit. How is Mimpoike going to respond? We're 8 seconds away from his Iron Bark. Still 5 seconds away. He's stunned up. Can't Void Shift. Still low on health. Void Shift to Mimpoike. Do they switch to Mimpoike is another question. Not going to be able to. He's repositioned. Villai managing to keep it calm, cool, and collected. But burning your Void Shift, a 5-minute cooldown this early on, you can already tell that the boys are bringing the pressure.
Yeah, I actually really don't like this matchup for Change My Mind. I think they would have to have the Windwalker on their team for the off-healing, because Villai is just, he's just under so much pressure. Like, the Death Knight just brings more damage, brings the Narcotic Strikes, the Death Grip as well for the Druid to deal with. It's just so much harder. And I mean, it's also just harder for Villai to cast. So the boys definitely with a good composition change here. They're trying to get a bit of damage over on Smexin. He's a bit more of an exposed target than the Fury Warrior was, but Greki trading out another nice life cocoon. We've seen it from him the entire series. Cyclone's coming in from Mimpoike to counter, but it's really changed my mind who are up against it.
Greki with a slight mana lead. Cooldowns in favor of the boys here in game number 2, but Smexin gets bursted. How are they going to trade? No cooldowns for a Maledict push on the side of Change My Mind. That is devastating. An anti-magic shield to avoid Mimpoike's. Now, 2 Glider's Maledicts out of the way. That means the boys can go, go, go. Villai in trouble. Very low on health. Dispersion available. Likely to have to make that exchange. He fades the incoming Glider's Maledict and some pressure at low health. Perfect timing on his part, but that mana is just an ever-so-burning resource for the side of Change My Mind. And Mimpoike needs to utilize the map, the big open field, to try and find a drink. Will he be able to do so? They need to work with with Valet to be able to dispel off the disease of the Unholy Death Knight so that he does not get put into combat. But Smexen's in trouble. There's no Glider's Medallion for Gurecki. Anti-Magic Zone stabilizes Smexen for now. Minpoike took advantage of that moment. When his team had pressure, he snuck away and was able to regenerate mana. Perfect awareness on Minpoike's part, and it's going to keep his team in the fight here for game two.
Yeah, it's a nice play. It's something we've seen quite a few of the European teams doing. They use the offensive Vendetta, force the boys defensive, and then use that opportunity for the healer to go for a drink. Minpoike, well played, able to restore his mana to floor. He has the Innovate back up, so good rotations here. The Life Swap, which was used by Villai, should be coming up in about 3 minutes here. So it's going to be up in time for dampening. So it might not end up being the worst punish in the world. We have the Greater Fade, of course, and the Dispersion and the Trinket from Minpoike available. And honestly, I think Change My Mind have started to stabilize a little bit in this matchup. So.
Way of the Crane activated. Big hits coming in. Dispersion and Evasion preemptively by Acro, anticipating a swap to himself when Valet goes immune to damage. Nice prediction on his part. He avoids some huge swap potential. Triple Mind Bomb by Valet as they look to counter aggress towards Smexen. Cyclone out of the Mind Bomb. Where's the bash? Minpoike moves in, secures it. Smexen's at half, but with no dampening, Deathstrike likely to stabilize Smexen. No Glider's Maledix to absorb its healing. One Deathstrike, Smexen stabilizes. Grecki's out of crowd control, but his mana's not looking too good. However, this map could also benefit him to sneak away and drink. Let's see if he can manage to do it. He did it in game one and immediately won the game off the back of a drink. If he has Way of the Crane and dampening, it's almost impossible for Change My Mind to heal through the pressure, but they need to get to that point. Smexen's low.
Yeah, actually, the Death Knight is starting to turn into a bit of a liability here because the Shadow Priest does damage so gradually. The Death Strikes aren't actually that effective against him because it basically the way it works is Death Strike heals you based on the damage you took in the last 6 seconds. And both the Assassination Rogue and the Shadow Priest do high, consistent damage, but not really anything particularly bursty. So Smexen struggling to keep himself at high health, meaning Grecki's having to spend a lot of mana, and more importantly, meaning he's having to consistently heal rather than go for those drinks. So as long as he struggles to stay, I could see Change My Mind maybe winning this one on mana. Dampening started to stack. Acro, of course, he shouldn't be as scared against the Death Knight. Beautiful. He gets a beautiful sap here coming in from Acro. Doesn't have the Trinket or the Evasion, but I think it's unlikely they'll swap to him.
Look at Minpoike. He's ready. He's in prime position to secure crowd control for his team. If they can get the Glider's Medallion without blind, they can find victory through that. But not enough. Maybe enough of the silence. A few more seconds. Smexen's trying to hold out. Grecki rolls in. It's Way of the Crane time. Acro, you don't have evasion. There's no Iron Bark. And Poike's in crowd control. This could easily be it. Acro, so low on health, manages to retreat away. And Poike now out of crowd control, but he's got to heal two members through a ton of damage. Dispersion exchange. Valet stabilizes. Change My Mind. Keep it cool.
Yep, you can see the Void Shift, that Life Swap available for Villai in about 45 seconds. Huge defensive cooldown if they can survive to it. This was the Abomination. See that lovely fella there on your screens, massive with all the hooks, slaying right now. Big damage for the Death Knight, but it should expire momentarily. And once it does, I think we can see Villai and Acro start to get stabilized. Minpoike had to burn through a fair bit of mana, but he's actually taken a lead over Grecki. And maybe, just maybe, you know, the Vendetta is up in about a minute. If they can burn down his mana pool and go for one big kill with that over on Smexen, I could easily see them securing this game.
Yep, but change my mind, down the clock. No mana really left on either side as dampening mounts up to close to 10%. Acro, he's constantly positioning in a way to try and avoid a double leg sweep while still keeping up his rupture. His awareness has been great to the swap potential, and he knows that he's a vulnerable target for another 20 seconds, but he stacks up. They could swap. They see the opportunity. They go after Acro. He gets life gripped, but not actually too far away. And with only Feint, I'm not sure if that's going to be enough. He shadow melts the Glider's Maledict, avoids some incoming pressure. Kidney shots Smexen to stall for a few seconds to allow Minpoike to stabilize. Luckily for Minpoike, his Innervate available. All of his healing is free. He manages to not even recover with that much free healing. Acro's still so low on health. The boys have huge pressure.
Yeah, Acro is starting to rot down a little bit. That's one of the disadvantages. The Rogue doesn't have as much self-healing as he would, say, on a Windwalker Monk. But at the same time, Acro, he knows that. He's playing it smart. He's trying to, you know, weave in and out a little bit, gets to see onto Grecki, posture pressure whilst not taking too much himself. The Vendetta now available. We see Villai with that Void Eruption active right now. The Insanity, big damage coming out. Grecki almost out of mana. They force the Life Cocoon with the Vendetta. Can they burst through it? They're looking for it, but Acro just being kind of kited and slowed by the Chains of Ice. You can even see the Fist of Fury coming in from Chun-Li. Smart plays from the boys, making sure Acro can't play the game to the extent he needs to.
Two targets low on health, and Poike has absolutely no mana left. Dispersion keeps Valet alive, but for how much longer? Minpoike is locked down in crowd control with his already completely devastated mana bar. He's managed to sneak away. Can they stop him? How much mana is he going to get? He could completely carry the game back. The Ring of Peace misses. He misses. If Valet doesn't die, I think Minpoike... Not really a lot, but it's better than nothing.
I mean, that Rigger piece missing is definitely a life changer for Change My Mind. They needed it. Now we see the Void Shift coming out to kind of recover from the fact that they had to use that drink. I mean, Poike has his trinket up momentarily here. Vilai with no defensive, so he's using the Vampiric Embrace, doing what little healing he can. We see the Smoke Bomb. They're doing whatever they can in this situation to try get some kind of semblance of counter pressure, but I'm not sure it's going to be enough. Iron Bark available from Mpoike. He's being a little bit greedy with it. Maybe just trying to save it for the Way of the Crane from Greki. I'm not entirely sure. Uses it now. They have nothing left. One more Onslaught, Sid, could easily be the game for the boys.
Yep, and they've got enough mana for Way of the Crane. Greki could easily close this game out with both Acro and Valet vulnerable. No Iron Bark for another 45 seconds. Really only the remaining amount of mana that Mpoike managed to scrounge back together, but he looks like he's trying to drink again, but you cannot drink, I don't believe, in this position. Valet is in so much trouble, trying to hold out, trying to stall. Ring of Peace denies the drink, but he did manage to get some mana, some semblance of opportunity, despite being down their fourth member, quite possibly their most important member, their mage. Change My Mind. Can they manage to hold it together a bit longer? No. They are going to get overwhelmed in game number two in the go. The gates have opened, Adrian.
You know what the best thing will be, Sid, if the boys win the series?
What will it be?
It means that we'll have had four series of EU vs NA, and we will round out the day with another four series of EU vs NA. I love the spring finals, dude. Every single time, you know, we have the top teams in EU vying against each other, the top teams in NA. This is where we bring them together and really prove once and for all, or at least for a few months, which are the best, you know? Will it be the European teams? Will it be the North American teams? So far, it's been the number one and two seeds from both regions doing fantastically. Chun-Li caught up a little bit. This is the early blind touch of Karma used. Is it going to be enough, though? Diffuse as well. Fortify every single cooldown. Gripped by the Vortex out of the zone there as well. Huge play from Mpoike and an excellent start for Change My Mind.
All right, Chun-Li transcendences back out of line of sight, catches a life cocoon, stabilizes, and then jumps right back into the fight as Valet gets bursted. It's match point for Change My Mind. They cannot afford any mistakes, but they've still got good pressure. Chun-Li is totally exposed here on game three. Valet just needs to hold out a tad bit longer, getting interrupted on Vampiric Touch, spamming out those purges with the Twist of Magic, able to heal up his team as well. Good utility choice on Valet's part, really highly customized very well against this composition to try and stall out the game and dispel all of those renewing mists, which effectively counter the Shadow Priest class when talented into counteract magic. So Valet's playstyle, his customization is perfect, but still may not be enough to overcome the huge amount of pressure that the boys bring here in this series, the last series of the upper bracket. You don't want to go anywhere.
Yeah, I mean, really, this is a game where the boys can secure it. You know, we talked about it already, this kind of even split between EU and NA, but Vilai and Acro are doing absolutely anything within their power to deny that, or at least cause a battle for it. They're not going to go down without a fight. Fried Kitty or no Fried Kitty, this team have shown a lot of resilience here, and they're looking like they have the opportunities. Touch of Death coming out from Chun-Li. He's trying to get some damage over onto Acrylaws. The evasion runs out. Vilai, I think he has to call to trade if it was onto him here. The dispersion is still available, of course. Iron Bark from Mpoike preemptively on all of this crowd control. Both these healers have been excelling, honestly, this series.
Yeah, great predictions on both parts of Mpoike and Gurecki. Chun-Li's down at half, caught in the stun. Life Cocoon. Greki anticipating some crowd control and just wants to avoid some pressure during this moment in time, but now Vendetta will be open. Although Anti-Magic Zone is likely to be the trade that Smexin makes with that cooldown. We do see that trade quite frequently and those cooldowns lined up currently, so he's going to be the one that needs to save Chun-Li. Will he be able to? Valet under pressure, no Iron Bark, but a huge Swift Man catches him and stabilizes. Once again, big map selected by Change My Mind to try and allow drinks. We see crowd control on two members. Perfectly timed to deny that Anti-Magic Zone. Just a few extra seconds and potentially pull even more defense from Chun-Li. He's able to transcendence out of line of sight. Mpoike moving over on top of him as well, but Acro not able to get there. And once again, Chun-Li is just a Windwalker monk that never dies.
Yeah, this is where you start to bring in that question, right? Like, who are the best Windwalker monks in the world right now? Chun-Li is playing this series fantastically.
As I say that.
In the kidney, though, does have the Trinket Karma. He will trade it out. Could be in a bit of trouble through that. Greki does have Life Cocoon. They won't want to overlap too many cooldowns. Vendetta wasn't even exchanged here. It's just big damage. But Chun-Li has been kiting fantastically. Forces the Greater Fade on Vilai. Dispersion still available. He should be fine. Mana pretty even once again here as the Way of the Crane comes out for Greki.
Two members low on health, and Poike playing it patiently. Doesn't want to overcommit that Iron Bark to a target and have them switch to the other. So he's holding on to it for quite some time. But that's costing him mana to try to kind of brute force heal through the pressure, and now he is at a disadvantage to Gorecki. If the boys can deny his drink, the boys will continue to mount a lead there, and it's match point for them. That's not looking too good for Change My Mind. Crowd control engaged. Gorecki saw it coming. Pre-life cocoons at incoming setup, and once again denies an opportunity for Change My Mind. That may have been the kill window. There was no cooldowns there unless Gorecki preempted that. Although now pressure into two places, Smexin gets bursted down. Then they switch over to Chun-Li. Smexin gets cloned at low health. Gorecki's going to have to try and deal with this without getting crowd controlled if Minpoike decides to cross against midfield. Cycloning up Chun-Li, stalling it out. Minpoike's moving over. He's going to jump over. Not able to find any crowd control. Stunned up by Smexin. Clotheslined immediately, and Gorecki repositions to avoid any crowd control. Good teamwork from Smexin to protect Gorecki.
Yeah, that was good defense there from the boys, I think. Something they've been doing a great job of. But I do want to talk a little bit about the strategy change that Change My Mind seems to have adopted here. They're putting more spread pressure onto Chun-Li and Smexin. Most of the kidney shots are on Chun-Li, since he has less crowd control breakers than the Death Knight. But most of the kind of in-betweeny damage is being put onto Smexin. I actually really like this. I think it taxes Gorecki a little bit more. Gives the boys more to think about, honestly. And in a, you know, it's one composition coming out of Change My Mind. It's pretty one-dimensional. And the more they can kind of change it up mid-game, it might help them out. We see another preemptive life cocoon coming out from Gorecki. Vendetta is available here. This could be an opening, Sid.
Let's see what they can get done. They're going to pop that. Where's the anti-magic zone? That's likely been the defense that Smexin trades. He's holding out onto it. Touch of Karma instead. No overlap in the defensive lineup of the boys, but sap out a Mind Bomb with no Glare's Medallion. That's a Touch of Karma immediately by Chun-Li. And an anti-magic zone, but Valet equally low on health. A couple more seconds to a trinket on Gorecki's part, but if he trinkets anything but a blind, he's vulnerable to that moving forward. There's no follow-up. Valet manages to shackle the Abomination, stall out the push, and somehow stay alive. Minpoike has managed to scrounge some mana back and get a significant lead over Gorecki, but now Valet gets bursted. Dispersion trades for him. Minpoike once again keeping his team in the fight, finding a drink and regenerating mana. Critical moves here for Change My Mind if they want to stay up in this upper bracket.
Yeah, they're actually going for the kill here. Looks like Chun-Li on the retreat. He has no defensive cooldowns remaining. Acrylos looking for a little re-stealth here. Potentially could be something going. Gorecki crosses the map. But, I mean, he's so far away from his healer. Chun-Li, he's going to get caught here. Acrylos throwing daggers, throwing anything. Trinket, Fist of Fury trying to stay alive. He's come into Villai's line of sight. Another Malzik, and surely Chun-Li will fall. What is this? How is he still alive? The life cocoon from Gorecki in the nick of time, and the boys somehow, some way, survive on Tolvaron.
Cockroaches survive nuclear apocalypses, and so does Chun-Li. He's just the monk that never dies. You cannot take him down. Will he finally fall here? There's no cooldowns. 10 seconds away. Chun-Li portals, but finally, maybe a mistake. Ring of Peace denies the connect. Chun-Li catches a Vivify, gets dispelled from the dots, slowly but surely stabilizes. Minpoike takes the opportunity, though, to drink, regenerate mana, and try and build a lead there, but man, Chun-Li is on fire today.
Dude, Chun-Li spends hours per day playing double Windwalker in twos. You'll probably have seen it on any top North American player's stream, and this guy just lives. Like, that comp should not work, but it works because this guy, this Chun-Li guy, he's so hard to kill, it's so hard to catch him. You can feel the frustration in my voice. Imagine what Change My Mind are feeling right now. As once again, Chun-Li gets away with his life. He has the Touch of Karma, he has the Diffused Magic, but they do have a massive mana lead since they've been using the map very well. Minpoike's been going for those drinks, he has the Innovate. I'd still say, despite all the big plays coming out of the boys and Chun-Li, Change My Mind still lead this game.
Yeah, they've got a good lead here, but it's on match point. They got to swing it three in a row, but let's see if they can do it. Despite not having their mage player, they're keeping it together, but how much longer? The pressure's mounting. Valet's in trouble, so low on health. Dampening isn't going anywhere but up. Minpoike is in crowd control. Dispersion is fading shortly, but Valet is stabilized. Acro's trying to dodge a stun. He knows he's vulnerable. With no evasion, no Glider's Medallion, he's got to get away from the fight, but he can't. Smexin's holding him too close to the fray. Chun-Li gets stunned up. Gorecki gets crowd control. They got a couple seconds to kill Chun-Li. Can they take him down is the question. I don't want to question him, but this should be the situation where we see him killed. He's bashed up. He's silenced. He has Touch of Karma. He's going to connect that, stay in the fight. Gorecki dispels. Chun-Li still low on health. Minpoike gets stunned. Acro gets stunned. He's still the target here with no defense. Cloak needs to be enough. Chun-Li's Touch of Karma is finally faded, and how are you going to do it? Gorecki's interrupted. He can't life cocoon for one more second.
Come on.
One more second.
What?
Chun-Li pulls away
again.
At 1%. Life cocoon. Chun-Li catches a heal. stays alive. Is he going back in at that low health? I think that might be a mistake. Way of the Crane gets activated, but he gets stunned on it. Good punish from Acro, and the monk that never dies. Will he finally go down? Touch of Death is available. Can they take Valet out? If they've got a stun, he's not going to be able to Void Shift. He's already low on health. He fades. Now there's no fade for the Touch of Death, and Chun-Li's ready to close this, I think.
Yeah, he may well. He needs to go for it soon, though. That dispersion comes up in 18 seconds. I'd love to see just Chun-Li throw
it. There it is.
Chun-Li throws out the Touch of Death. Huge incoming damage onto Valet. He has no trinket. If they stun him up, he won't even be able to use the Void Shift. We see a kidney, though, from Chun-Li. This is the Void Eruption. Insanity unleashed on the boys. Changed my mind, looking to change the course of this series. Gurecki completely out of mana. Chun-Li on the run, but this is what I said in game one. Keep attacking Chun-Li, and it's so hard for the boys to close out the game. Even though he's surviving it, it looks fantastic. He's not dealing any damage. This is a melee about 40 yards away from a Shadow Priest. This is not a match you will win the way it's going right now. Change my mind, have the strategy. They have the tools here, and this kidney shot surely said they're going to get the kill.
Oh my. Chun-Li stays alive, gets like a little health, pressure on two targets. Perfect play by Change My Mind, although the mana that Minpoke has managed to regenerate throughout this fight is almost completely burned out once again. The Life Cocoon fades. There's not much defense left really here. Can the boys hold on? Vendetta being denied by this purple anti-magic zone shield. All the damage being absorbed, but now that shield's defense has faded. Smexon's still low on health. Acro is tearing in. Two targets low, no mana left. How much longer can Gurecki go? Change My Mind, they're suddenly pulling this fight back. Great play on their part, despite being a man down. Smexon holds out. Is he gonna go down? Yes, the Glyre's Maledict connects the kill. Change My Mind, stay alive in the upper bracket.
A 3-0. The question is, can Change My Mind find a reverse sweep?
Change My Mind playing outstanding, showing that they are certainly not chickens. Buck, buck, buck here on the hook. Point. Can they bring it back two more games in a row? If they manage to do so, that is going to mean three European teams advancing the upper bracket, only one North American team. Early crowd control engaged onto Gurecki, and Chun-Li, once again, his defense will be put to the test.
You know what? It's difficult because the boys knew what Change My Mind were going to play from the start. So we know this is the best options the boys have, in their opinion at least. And even on the small map, I mean, the small map definitely helps the cleave. They're going to find an easier time stopping Minpoke going for those drinks. I truly believe that Change My Mind could reverse sweep this. There's no reason. I don't think the matchup is as favored as it looks on paper. We'll have to see, though, because the small map will definitely help the boys. We see the Touch of Death committed from Chun-Li once again over onto Vilay, but not too much doing. Of course, the dispersion is available should it be needed. Big pressure coming out onto Chun-Li as Gurecki once again sitting that blind sap in the opener. Could potentially be a greedy play. Touch of Karma, sorry, still available for Chun-Li, but he's sitting low, and this isn't the kind of situation you want to be in as the boys.
It's actually a mind bomb sap, so if Gurecki trinkets that and gets blinded later on, it's a very scary moment that we've seen time and time again from Change My Mind. Way of the Crane activated. Cycloned. Denied by Minpoike. Chun-Li on the run. Acro in hot pursuit. Valet on the Shadow Priest. Not going to be moving fast enough to really chase down a Windwalker, but Chun-Li just rolls back into the fight. Valet jumps into Void Form, trying to dish out some pain here. Gurecki's still just attacking. He could be vulnerable to crowd control pushed this far up. Minpoike is really going at it, always utilizing every single global cooldown, tossing in some couple Solar Wraths when there's not enough damage going out, looking for Cyclones, trying to slow it down, really playing to the best of his ability here in game number four against the boys, battling against all odds without their mage player, Fried Kitty, managing to at least put a point on the board and showing that they've still got it.
Yeah, I really like the Mind Bomb pick from Change My Mind, firstly, because it's so hard for Vilay to move his character. It's just an excellent way of landing what is essentially a substitute for fear. That said, I'm really surprised Gurecki isn't running the reverse magic, because you can basically, like, the way that Change My Mind sets up the CC is Vilay silences into the Mind Bomb. He could just reverse all of that crowd control on about a 1.5 minute cooldown, I believe it is. So maybe that's something potentially Gurecki could adapt to. We see full Mind Bomb once again here. Chun-Li, the trade with that purple bubble, the anti-magic zone on the Vendetta. Good plays from the boys. Smexin once again on point with that cooldown. But this has been another case of, like, you know, Minpoike's burning through his mana faster than Gurecki. If they can stop the drinks, the boys will win this because of the small map. If they can't, Change My Mind are going to take it to another dangerous late game for Chun-Li.
I mean, it's do or die here. Change My Mind are still on match point in the upper bracket as the boys look to close it out. Blind, where's the Glyre's Medallion? He's not going to do it because Chun-Li got Cyclone. Maybe a bit of a miscommunication on the side of Change My Mind. Now Valet low on health. Iron Bark stabilizes over there. Sap, Chun-Li on the run. Acro connects. Cheap shot, low on health. No touch of Karma. Danger time, 10 seconds away from a life cocoon. Maybe we see a Way of the Crane. Way of the Crane immediately. Grecki charges in, but he walks into a stun. He has to glider his medallion out of that. Now, later on, Mind Bomb Sap, Blind Sap. This push, this aggressive play by Grecki to try and close the fight out if they don't get a kill is now a liability moving forward.
I would say that was a frustrated for Trinket. I don't think he needed to use it. They still had the touch of Karma if it was really needed, and they're not going to get a kill on Vili here. He has the Greater Fade, he has the Dispersion. They're trying to play more aggressively because they have that mana pressure on Minpoike, is the only thing I can think of. Grecki has the big mana lead, and they're trying to convert it into a win, and they need to generate pressure. They need to go for those big aggressive plays if they are to do that. We see Dispersion traded for the Touch of Death. Nice trade from Vili that, of course, 1.5 minute cooldown. Square there, so perfectly reasonable on the side of Changed My Mind. And Vili still under a little bit of pressure. The Void Shift coming in. Maybe the boys going for this kind of more aggressive strategy is going to pay off for them here because, I mean, Minpoike did get a drink, but they lost a lot of cooldowns for it.
This is the first time I've seen First Aid actually have value.
Yeah, Akro, first aid, MVP.
Clutch play there. Akro gets stunned. Three members get stunned. Big error here by Changed My Mind. Potentially series on the line. Akro gets life crypt away, but even still so low on health. And Poike managed to get mana. That is of utmost importance in this matchup if he wants to stay ahead of Grecki as we get closer and closer to dampening. Let's look at the opportunities. Vendetta available, but Vire's Medallion, Touch of Karma, and any magic zone on the side of the boys. Their defense is looking unbreakable. Pre-fortifying elixir by Chun-Li. This is just a monk that refuses to die. Cycle no at low health, and Poike tries to switch it over to Grecki. Gets denied by that paralysis. Grecki needs to reposition, but he's walking into midfield. Walks with a silence mind bomb into Chun-Li. Chun-Li's still low on health. Touch of Karma keeps him going during this crowd control, but Sap, no Glider's Medallion. Touch of Karma's going to be fading here shortly. How much longer can Chun-Li stay alive? This crowd control chain is just looking solid. Another Sap by Akro. Minpoike may be looking for a Cyclone. Gets stunned. He can't do it. He gets cheap shot. Akro hard carrying the crowd control. Minpoike in position. Another stun. That was 1 second too late. Life Cocoon. Death Grip stops the Cyclone. They need another stop. They get interrupted. Ring of Peace bounces Minpoike away. If that bash was even 1 second faster, that may have been Chun-Li's life, and we could have been going to a game five. How much longer can Minpoike keep this going? His mana just burning down so quickly. Now crowd controlled. Akro in trouble. Ironbark activated preemptively by Minpoike. Akro holds on by a thread, but Smexen is just tearing him to pieces. The boys advance.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.